It's Hannah.
It's Tina, and this is By the Graces. If you've been with us for a while, you've seen our previous reaction videos to our favorite K-pop artists such as GOT7 and Blackpink. For today's video, we are going to do something different. It's not going to be a reaction video to a K-pop artist, but of P-pop, Pinoy pop.
Pinoy pop music.
Yes. We are going to react to SB19's Love Goes Day and Night dance practice video.
So we have always wanted to react to an SB19 video because we're really big fans of them. This is the latest video they have on YouTube.
So for those of you who don't know, SB19 is the first P-pop boy group trained under a Korean company.
In the Philippines. So they've gone all through this Korean, this rigorous training that K-pop idols have been through, and they always exceed their expectations.
Yeah.
Whenever
Philippine
they,
pride.
Yeah, Philippine pride. P-pop rise. So SB19 has five members. It's Sejun, Stell, Ken, Justin, and Josh.
So let's get to it.
So we wore...
Because we're blind.
We're blind. 2020 vision who?
Oh yes, stream, get into zone, guys. for clear skin. They recently released their album called Get in the Zone, and there you can find or you can listen to all their songs.
The whole time I was trying to control myself because there are people who know us in real life watching this. Wala bang ano dyan?
Wala bang init? So this is Love Goals, and it's from their first ever digital album called Get in the Zone. I think it's available in all platforms.
Yeah, it's available in all platforms.
Stream highly suggested.
So is there anything else you want to say?
Actually, there's a lot I want to say about SB19. When did you start being a fan ba?
Oh, I just started recently. We actually just got into them very recently, but I don't know, it already feels like a family.
Oh, yeah. Kasi, ano, I've been like a casual listener before their viral video go up. Yeah. Dance practice like became viral. Our younger sister like introduced me and said, Ate Hannah, there's this boy group pala in the Philippines. She showed me the music video of Go Up, and then at that time I only knew Till Luha and Go Up. I think these guys, they really have potential and they can really make it big. I don't know, as a Filipino, it's
nakaka-proud lang siya.
Kasi although I hopped in for the curiosity, I guess I'm just staying for their story kasi parang my essence kasi yung pinagdaanan nila in life. They're very rich in experiences. Kaya as Filipinos or as humans, parang you could relate and learn from their experiences.
Especially us as Filipinos, we have relatable experiences with them compared to, of course, K-pop idols.
Yeah, I think there's that connection. That's why it's different. I mean, you know us, we've been like fans of GOT7 and of other groups.
Yes.
But I think this one, it's different because as a Filipino, supporting your fellow Filipino group, it's like, ano eh, although it's really new in the Philippines, they really are like proving that they're breaking into the music industry with their sound.
They really pushed through para sa dreams nila. Ang dami nang pinagdaanan na, syempre ang dami nang hate, ang daming masakit na salita, and they walked on bubog. So your faves can
you know, it's very common. I mean, if you're not a Filipino, then it's very common in the Filipino culture that yung goals mo in life, like you always have to study, and then after graduating college, you have to start working and supporting your family. And sometimes your dreams, and even if you are passionate about something, you push that aside because you know you have responsibilities. These guys, they like went against the current. They didn't just go with the flow, and we can see why they're here now. And kasi we're also part of the fandom itself. It's just not...
We're very active on Twitter. For those of you guys who are watching that are part of the Twitter community, you might have already interacted with us.
Hey, we haven't mentioned, we're 18.
Yeah, 18. We're 18. No, 18 silent S.
18 without an S, magagalit si Juan Pablo. You know, in the fandom, it's... Hindi naman lagi masaya, hindi laging nasa taas, hindi perfect, walang... But then, their presence there like makes you feel na, ay, this is ano pala, parang they really want to know us. And then, yeah, it's very common to see kasi bago nga sila in the Philippines, you see a lot of comments na negative. And you see mga people who are saying that this group has a lot of things to improve on pa. So for me, improvement is like a journey. You won't get there.
It's
and then,
a process.
Oh, it's a process. And then, mas gusto ko na I'm part of the process, I'm part of the journey. I don't want to be there for the hype, like I want to be there for
the journey. Like yung sabi mo nga, because of SB19, people are like feeling na...
Oh, kaya na,
ito na yung muta ako. Anyway, yakin lang talaga ako, but sabi nga...
So ayun nga, I've seen a lot of tweets. Feeling nila pag na-achieve na SB19 yung dreams nila, nag-resonate with them. Even if they're not in the stage yet. Oh, yung parang walang impossible, like kaya din nila abutin. And it's for us din kasi ako. But you just ask yourself, like Hannah, where do you want to see yourself 5 years from now? Are you going to take risks para sa dreams? Kagabi, I've been rereading Josh's thread, yung pinned tweet niya on Twitter. Kasi syempre yung pinagdaanan niya, hindi rin easy. And we could relate to that kasi although in a different context, although we're from a different country. And also Ken, yung he shared his conversation with his dad on Messenger. Syempre there you can see na yung pinagdaanan pala nila, hindi pala basta-basta.
And they're always willing to share their vulnerabilities with the fans. So you feel like you're closer to them in a way.
Iba kasi, being vulnerable then it also has power and also has impact in people's lives.
If you're an 18, alam mo naman yung nangyari the past weeks. Tapos yung parang nag-thread pa si Stel.
Yeah,
na
yesterday.
Parang thoughtful. It actually
picked at my heartstrings. Small heartstrings. When I read that, syempre, me being the iyakin that I am, I'm moot na naman ako. We were talking about it nang kagamit. I was
basta
like,
iyak na kami.
Umiyak na kami dito na, I'm not as Whitney Stan.
Yeah, because yung messages nila, sobrang heartfelt. Like, yung tagus.
That's what made us
stay. For me, parang yung pagiging fan ng SB19 is like reading a book.
Mm-mm.
Na you can't wait to read every chapter kasi you know that there's gonna be a good ending. Or you can't wait to see the ending. And at the same time, ayaw mo mag-end kasi the book, matatapos at matatapos talaga siya. 1D.
Enjoy it but it lasts na lang and make the most of it.
Yung mga, for the bashers, I have to something to say about that. Kasi as humans, we live and we share the same skies. Pero, we can gaze at different stars. The star you're looking at doesn't make the star I'm looking at less than a star. At the end of the day, they still shine.
So like, kayo you know, mga bashers.
Chupi.
Chupi.
You know what, Tina, yung SB19, nag-lurk sila.
Yeah, nag-lurk nga sila.
So what if they...
So kung nanonood man sila nito, like... If I have a message for them, edi ano na lang.
Okay.
They already know this naman, pero... You know, just don't pay attention to the bashers kasi you're starting pa lang naman. And you're gonna reach the heights. Just wait for it. Kasi kami na bahala dyan. Just do your thing and we do our thing and we're gonna rise up together.
Siguro for SB19, my message is now kasi numbers are a big deal. Kapag makita yung sobrang laking followers mo, sobrang dami mong views, parang yun na yung factor ng success. Pero it's not that. I think it's more about like the impact you have sa people on a personal level, and that you will never know kasi you're not the fan, eh. Kayo yung idol, and you will never know the impact you have sa fans nyo. And whenever they say na hindi nila deserve yung mga pinagdadaanan nila,
so parang manakal.
Oh, parang sabi ko, ha, really ba? But why am I here if they're not deserving? And I'm not here for the hype. I'm here because I've seen something in them, and kasi deserving sila. Feeling ko naman talaga nanonood sila. No? What if hindi naman sila nanonood?
Pretend na nanonood.
Pretend din na lang nandiyan kayo. So, yeah, if you're watching this, don't ever for a second think na hindi niyo deserve kasi if people did not say something na kahanga-hanga sa inyo, then I think no one would stay.
Just so, the fact na ang daming supporters means deserving kayo.
So, yeah.
Duh. Stop, man. Like,
stop.
Okay, anyway, haba-haba na.
Yeah.
But you get what we mean.
Yeah, you get what
naging
we mean.
Pep talk na to yung reaction natin.
No, kasi yeah, I think that's the end of the video. We just had fun talking about SB19. We're not reacting as casual listeners, but as 18. And I think we gave you a scope on like how it is to be part of the fandom. Kahit konti. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you made it this far, if you're an 18, you can comment down below if ano yung mga parang like. Ano yung
ka-relate kayo,
ka-relate kayo or your journey as an 18.
Yeah. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more.
And you can also turn on the post notification bell so you can be notified whenever we have a new video out.
Thank you so much for watching this video and staying until this far. This was
By the Graces.
Bye-bye.